now, from Alaska's sports leader, here's Beth O'Donnell.
We may have just gotten into the summer season, but around this time of year, mushers are already focusing on the last great race. The Iditarod held its annual volunteer picnic this afternoon in Wasilla, which also serves as the official start of the sign-up period for next year's race. A total of 62 mushers registered today, 37 were on hand, while the rest mailed in their entry. And it's not too late for those still wanting to participate. The deadline to sign up isn't until Tuesday, December 1st. Experience varies amongst those registering, from an out-of-state rookie to the reigning champion.
Young blood is always good for a sport, and I hope that our success in the past years helps get people into it. It's a long, tough road, though, from your first couple Iditarods to trying to make it to the top.
Being out of state, it's something new to me. I'm not used to sled dogs being from New York, but there are some around there, and now I have the opportunity to come up here and just go on with bigger and better things. So while I have that opportunity, I'm trying to take advantage of it.
Among the list of mushers registered, five are previous champions, including Mitch and Dallas Seavey, Jeff King, Martin Boozer, and Robert Sorley. What do you get when you mix strongmen man types and skirts? The Alaska Scottish Highland Games, of course. Okay, so they're not exactly skirts, but had I said kilts, it would have given it away. The 34th annual event took place this afternoon at the State Fairgrounds. Games include caber toss, which is kind of like chucking a giant telephone pole. I already know if I had attempted that, I would have gotten smacked in the face. But everyone stayed safe out there. In fact, two field records were broken. Spencer Tyler of Liberty Hill, Texas, set a mark in the men's open stone with a heave of 48 feet, 4¾ inches. And then Jenny McDaniel of Anchorage in the women's weight for distance delivers a heave of 34 feet, 6 inches to set a new record.
It's a comfort thing as far as the stones are concerned. As far as these weights, use the hook grip. You see everybody's got their thumbs taped up or wearing gloves. But, hook grip is preferred for this.
Oh, it's such a rush. Yeah, it's and to hear the crowd and my friends and family out here is awesome. And it's awesome. I'm so excited right now.
Three Alaskan athletes are participating in the USA Track and Field Championships down in Eugene, Oregon. Paige Blackburn of Soldotna took 14th in javelin last night, and today the 2012 Olympic bronze medalist and former Eielson student Janae Deloche notched third in the long jump with a 22-foot, 9¾-inch mark. Former NCAA champion Jordan Clark of Anchorage competes tomorrow in the shot put. Recent reports have been suggesting that Anchorage isn't a hockey city. But I disagree, and apparently so do the Tampa Bay Lightning. Former East High student Chris Oldham was selected in the sixth round, 153rd overall today by the Eastern Conference champions. The 6'2", 203-pound goaltender turned 18 Thursday. Well, that's a nice little belated birthday gift from the NHL. Oldham played two seasons with the Kenai River of North American Hockey League, and in his final season with the Omaha Lancers of the USHL, Oldham went 21-6-4 with a .908 save percentage and 2.49 goals against average. The goalie committed to Nebraska Omaha, which made the Frozen Four last season. Only three ABL games occupy the schedule tonight, and just one of them is a league matchup between the Pilots and the Chinooks. The Pilots take the win 13-2. Kevin Veers having a standout night, 3-for-4 with one run and three RBIs. The Bucks defeat the Studs 1-0. Stephen Lohr, the game hero, with the walk-off homer in the 11th. And in Fairbanks, the Merchants Gold Panthers game was canceled due to rain. Los Angeles took on Miami this afternoon inside Marlins Park for game two of their three-game series. Top of the first, right off the bat, pun kind of intended, Justin Turner homers to left center field, his 11th home run of the season, putting the Dodgers up 1-0. Bottom of the second, Miami up 2-1, Tom Kohler at bat. Jock Peterson almost gets the snow cone catch, but drops the ball. JT Realmuto scores 3-1 Marlins. The Dodgers go on to score one more, but the Marlins prevail 3-2. And speaking of the Marlins, some crushing news today for Miami. Slugger Giancarlo Stanton is out 4 to 6 weeks with a broken wrist bone. Stanton broke the hamate bone in his left wrist Friday night in the team's 7-1 loss against the Dodgers. The right fielder has been placed on the 15-day disabled list and is expected to have surgery. Stanton currently leads the league in home runs.
I'm not a fan of the Dodgers, so... I'm from Los Angeles. Oh my gosh.
Sorry.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry. Anyways, okay. We'll be right back.